Our involvement started with our CEO, Susan Dewey, back in, I think, 2019, when she saw a presentation about 3D housing and got excited and sent us off to do some more research.
So we at Virginia Housing have really been looking to see how we can increase inventory all across the state. And of course, we have to be innovative in how we do that. So we've been looking at things like modular housing, manufactured housing, a housing that looks like shipping containers, and of course, 3D printing. So we started right here in our backyard in Richmond. We've put together a great team that has brought this 3D process to life.
It's going through 90 feet of hose, which is not crazy.
We worked across architecture firms, engineering firms, local contractors, local developers, nonprofit housing groups, and then of course our wonderful sponsors involved in it.
We were able to provide a grant to buy the 3D printer itself.
It helped us figure out exactly how to do the method that we're trying to do. This is bleeding edge technology where we are right now. There's less than 5 companies doing this work in America today. To work with a group like Virginia Housing that cares so deeply for the state and has a singular mission and has been wildly successful doing it for years, we were honored to be selected, and also, of course, with Virginia Tech as an incredible partner.
One of the things that I think is very clear is we have such a need in the industry right now for efficiencies, and Virginia Housing has done a great job embracing a lot of different technologies and trying to bring them to the state of Virginia.
Really, housing affordability comes down to 3 things. It's the cost of the land, the cost of the labor, the cost of the materials. So anytime that we can get at one of those, we're getting somewhere.
Using this technology, we can drop the cost across the board to help people in these communities afford the homes.
Already, we've seen another house go up. We've had the company Alquist pledge to build 200 homes in Virginia. So it's paving the way, and you know, it's really cool because it's not just about this house, but it's looking ahead to looking at other building materials, other designs, looking how we can train the workforce to start being accustomed to using this type of technology. So, you know, we're really opening up a lot of doors by, you know, planting the seed here in Richmond.
Well, a lot of business deals with who's going to go first. And that's the toughest thing, to get the first project, to get the first development. And then the subsequent projects, they just seem to flow a little easier. So they're the first to really chart that path, blaze a trail, if you will.
That is what we're looking for, is to see that excitement continue east to west, north to south in Virginia, because there's a lot of excitement, and as we do more of these, we'll get better at scale. We're excited about the possibilities.
Because it's more than just technology, it's more than just innovation. A family's moving in, and that's important.
We are so excited that now it is actually built and we have a first-time home buyer that's going to be moving in.
Buying my first home makes me feel very excited. I'm happy to have home ownership. It's a great investment for my future.
I have seen this home from the beginning. This is what started everything, not only across Virginia, but across the country. But nothing compares to walking through that front door today and seeing how beautiful it turned out and getting a chance to talk to the homeowner, Tiffany, and her daughter, and really know that this is going to be much more than just a house. It's going to be a home.